Dear students, in this paper entitled as Forensic Toxicology, we shall be studying about what is meant by toxicology, which is basically dealing with the study of how the poisons are affecting. So we will understand the definition and the classification of poisons, how the poisoning happens, the routes of poison administration, and then what are the corresponding antidotes available. Going to the details of poisons, we will be also dealing with the various categories of poisons, like organic poisons, where the source, like they can be from plant or the animal poisons. Similarly, they can be microbial poisons. Then corrosive poisons, how the pesticides can act as poisons, the additive poisons, and then the inorganic poisons, where how the ions are acting as poisons, and then the cardiac poisons, the poisonous gases, the toxicokinetics, the neurotoxic poisons, the alcohol poisoning, the drug poisoning, and some other miscellaneous poisons we shall be studying in detail. And all this is very important from the forensic point of view. So we shall understand that how, as a forensic scientist, you shall be doing the diagnosis of these poisoning and the poisoning decontamination, how it can be done, and then the medico-legal aspect of poisoning we shall understand, and how the toxicological analysis is done, the various tests to detect that what is the poison intake which has been done, the extraction of poison methods from the, especially the biological matrices that we shall be understanding, and then the instrumental analysis, how that is useful in analyzing these poisons. And then obviously we shall try to understand the laws related to toxicology, and especially we shall target also on the doping in sports. So this shall be the outlay of this entire paper. And now coming to this particular module, it will be focusing on the introduction to the forensic toxicology. So if we try to look at the learning outcomes, dear students, after studying this module, you shall be able to know what is meant by forensic toxicology. You shall be able to identify the subdivisions of forensic toxicology and know the concept of forensic toxicology and its significance. Further, after studying this module, you shall be also able to know about the development and advancement of forensic toxicology. Now let us begin with the introduction to the term toxicology. The word toxicology has come from the Greek word toxikon, and this was used as a poisonous substance in the arrowheads at that time. Conventionally, the toxicology may be defined as the science representing the character, source, knowledge, lethal dose, fatal effect, analysis of poisons, and their curative measures. More precisely, toxicology can be said as the study of antagonistic effects of the chemical or physical agents on the living organisms like us. A toxicologist is competent to examine and lead into the nature of those effects on human, animal, and environmental health. The toxicological study examines the cellular, biochemical, and the molecular mechanism of action, as well as the functional effects such as neurobehavioral and immunological and assesses the likelihood of the event. The diversity of chemicals and that of their prospective adverse effects in the environment makes toxicology a comprehensive science, which often demands specialization in a specific range of toxicology. Our society's dependency on chemicals and the requirement to assess impending hazards have made the toxicologist an increasingly important part of the decision-making process. The existing description would be somewhat altered, but not necessarily be incorrect as it regards with the study and analysis of physical and chemical properties of poisons, where the physical properties means the appearance like color, state, other parameters being melting point, boiling point, etc. But when we come to chemical properties, the chemical properties have an important role, or you can say there is important characteristic which is associated with these molecules, in which the fatal dose, the toxicity, action upon the body, they are studied, including its metabolism. The added labor in the field of toxicology is the detection of any poison in the body, its qualitative as well as its quantitative estimation and interpretation of results of the respective toxicology analysis. Poison, if we talk about poison, may be regarded as any substance which, when taken in sufficient quantity, will cause ill health or death. The adage in this definition, you can say, and the point to be noted here is the sufficient quantity, and it may vary from different to different poisons. Some poison, they, if taken in small quantities, may not have so much adverse effects, but some of them are, even if taken in very minute quantities, can lead to immediate death. So with this background, let us try to know the history of toxicology also. The earlier Indian text Rig Veda in almost 12th century BC also describes several plant poisons. However, toxicology dates back to the earliest humans who used some plant extracts and animal venoms for warfare, hunting, and assassination. Elucidating the mechanism of the toxicity of venoms continues today in the field of toxicology. The knowledge of these poisons must have pre-existed detailed history. According to presumption, prehistoric humans characterized some plants as hazardous and others as safe. The same is possibly true for the classification of snakes from other animals. And similarly, there are so many animals which are poisonous, but some are not. The ancient book, Abel's Papyrus, it contains information pertaining to many known poisons, including the hemlock, aconite, opium, and even metals such as arsenic, lead, copper and antimony. Among the mineral poisons, one of the earliest known elements was lead, which was discovered as early as 3500 BC. Apart from its extensive use in plumbing, lead was also employed in the production of vessels and containers, and this led to pervasive chronic health problems. There is also a suggestion that plants containing substances similar to digitalis and belladonna, alkaloids, were known to them. Hippocrates kept various poisons and clinical toxicology principles relating to the bioavailability in remedy and overdosage, whereas the Book of Job states about the poison arrows. In the literature of ancient Greece, there are numerous references to poisons and their use. Some explanations of Homer, they have Odysseus containing toxins for his arrows. Going further in the historical perspective, Theophrastus, a student of Aristotle, comprised many references to poisonous plant in the book De Historia Plantarum. Dioscorides, a Greek physician in the court of the Roman Emperor Nero, did the first effort at a classification of poisons, and this was supplemented by the descriptions and diagrams. His classification went into the plant, animal, and mineral poisons, not only remained standard for 16 centuries, but also is still a very convenient classification. Dioscorides also experimented in remedy, identifying the use of emetics in poisoning and the use of caustic agents and cupping glasses in snake bite. Poisoning with plant and animal toxins was quite common. Perhaps the best known recipient of poison used as a state method of execution was Socrates in 470-399 BC, whose cup of hemlock extract was apparently estimated to be the proper dose for making that attempt. Although organic chemistry was in its nascent stage till 1800, but by 1825, war gases like phosgene, that is COCl2, and mustard gas, which is a sulfur containing compound, had been synthesized successfully. And these two agents, along with chlorine gas, they were used by German forces in World War I as the chemical warfare agents. They were stored throughout World War II, and they were used by Iraq in the Iran-Iraq War in 1980s, that is the Marine Corps history. By 1880, over 10,000 organic compounds had been manufactured, including chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, diethyl ether, and carbonic acid. Also, petroleum and coal gasification byproducts were used in trade. Experimental toxicology accompanied the growth of organic chemistry and developed rapidly during the 19th century. So, dear students, you see that toxicology will be now combining your background information of sub-chemistry part, and we'll see how it will have effect in the human body and so on. So let us now proceed further and try to know what are the various classifications which have been done to toxicology. The field of toxicology can be further divided into the following sub-disciplines. That is, we have the environmental toxicology, occupational toxicology, regulatory toxicology, food toxicology, clinical toxicology, descriptive toxicology, analytical toxicology, mechanistic toxicology, and forensic toxicology. So let us try to know the details of these different sub-disciplines. Talking about environmental toxicology. Environmental toxicology is concerned, as the name suggests, with the study of chemicals that contaminate our environment, that is food, water, soil, or atmosphere. It also deals with toxic substances that enter water bodies such as rivers, lakes, streams, and oceans. This category of toxicology describes the effect of exposure of toxic substances on living organisms like plant, animals, and human beings. Coming to the occupational toxicology. Occupational toxicology, or which is also called as industrial toxicology, is concerned with health effects from exposure to chemicals in the workplace, that is industry, you can say. This field grew out of a need to protect workers from the toxic substances and to make their work environment safe. Occupational diseases caused by industrial chemicals account for an estimated of 50,000 to 70,000 deaths and 350,000 cases of illness each year, which has been estimated in United States. According to WHO, there are 100 million occupational injuries causing almost 0.1 million deaths in the world. It is also estimated that 17 million occupational non-fatal injuries, that is around 17% of the world, and 45,000 fatal injuries, around 45% of the total deaths due to occupational injuries in the world, occur each year in India. Out of 11 million cases of occupational diseases in the world, 1.9 million cases are contributed by India, and out of these 0.7 million deaths in the world, that is, if you look at the deaths number, out of 0.7 million deaths in the world, 0.12 million deaths is contributed by India, that is almost around 17%. So this is alarming figure, and that's why this study also becomes important, not from forensic point of view, but otherwise. Regulatory toxicology. The regulatory toxicology gathers and evaluates existing toxicological information to establish the concentration-based standards of safe exposure. There are serious differences between the purposes and procedures of science and the regulatory policies. Science pursues to recognize the natural phenomena through unprejudiced, pragmatic, and impartial practices, and is careful, incremental, and evidence-based as well. Talking about food toxicology, as the name is very clear, food toxicology is involved in delivering a non-toxic and edible supply of food to the consumer. During processing, a number of substances may be added to the food to make it taste, smell, or look better. Fats, oils, sugars, starches, and other substances are usually added to change the texture and taste of food. And all of these additives, they are studied to conclude if and at what amount they may produce adverse effects. A second area of interest includes the food allergies. For example, many people have trouble in digesting milk, that is, they are lactose intolerant. Furthermore, toxic substances like pesticides may be applied to food crop in the field, while lead, arsenic, and cadmium are naturally present in soil and water, and they may be absorbed by plants. So toxicologists must determine what is the tolerable daily intake level for these substances, which can be considered as safe. Else they will be forming poisonous and will be affecting the health as well as can lead to death. Coming to clinical toxicology. Clinical toxicology is concerned with diseases and illness associated with short-term or long-term exposure to toxic chemicals. Clinical toxicologists include emergency room physicians who must be familiar with the symptoms related with exposure to an extensive variety of toxic substances in order to manage the appropriate treatment. Talking about descriptive toxicology. Descriptive toxicology is concerned with collecting toxicological statistics from animal experimentation. These types of experiments are used to establish how much of a chemical would cause illness or even death. So the experiment is done on animals, mainly mammals, because the same will be extended to the human beings. A descriptive toxicologist is concerned directly with toxicity testing, which provides information for safety evaluation and the regulatory requirements. The appropriate toxicity tests in cell culture systems or experimental animals are designed to yield information to assess the risk posed to humans and the environment from exposure to some specific chemicals. The concern here is that it may be limited to effects on humans, as in the case of drugs and food additives. Toxicologists in the chemical industry, however, must be concerned not only with the risk posed by a chemical like insecticide, herbicide, solvents, etc. to humans, but also with the potential effects on fish, birds, and plants, as well as other factors that might disturb the balance of the ecosystem. Descriptive toxicology is, of course, not separated from mechanistic studies. As such, studies provide important clues to a chemical's action, its mechanism, and consequently contribute to the development of mechanistic toxicology through hypothesis generation. And such studies are also a key component to risk calculation that are used by regulatory toxicologists. Let us now try to understand what is the analytical toxicology all about. Analytical toxicology, here again the name analysis, analytical. So this analytical toxicology identifies the toxicant through analysis of body fluids, stomach content, excrement or skin. It also comprises the application of the tools of analytical chemistry to the qualitative and or the quantitative assessment of chemicals that may exert effects on the living organisms. Generally, the chemical that is to be measured is xenobiotic that may have been altered or transformed by metabolic actions of the organism. Frequently, the specimen that is to be analyzed consists of a matrix composed of body fluids or solid tissues removed from the organism. And both the identity of the annelid and the complexity of the matrix can present difficulties to an analytical toxicologist. Coming to mechanistic toxicology. Mechanistic toxicology is the field which makes observation on how toxic substances cause their effects, that is on their mechanism. The effects of exposure can depend on a number of factors, including the size of the molecule, the exact tissue type or affected cellular components, whether the substance is easily soluble in water or more soluble in fatty tissues, all of which are very important when trying to determine the way a toxic substance can cause harm and whether effects seen in animals can be expected in a similar way in human beings. Now let us come to the branch which is forensic toxicology, where our main focus is. Forensic toxicology is used to help establish the cause and effect relationship between exposure to a drug or a chemical and the toxic or lethal effects that result from that exposure. Forensic toxicology talks about the application of conventional toxicology for the purposes of criminal investigation to assist legal administration. It can be considered as a hybrid of analytical chemistry and fundamental toxicology with advanced forensic medicine. Forensic toxicology is also primarily concerned with the medico-legal characteristics of the detrimental effects of chemicals on human and animals. The expertise of forensic toxicologists is primarily utilized in establishing the cause of death and interpreting its circumstances in post-mortem investigation. So with this background of the various sub-classification, let us move now in more detail with the forensic toxicology. So let us try to understand the concept of forensic toxicology in detail and its significance. For a forensic toxicologist, the mechanism of toxicity often provides perception as to how a chemical or physical agent can cause death or induce incapacitation. If the mechanism of toxicity is understood, descriptive toxicology becomes useful in predicting the toxic effects of related chemicals. Toxicity is actually the fundamental capacity of a chemical agent to affect an organism harmfully. And these agents are rather termed as xenobiotics, that is, foreign substance. Xenobiotics include drugs, industrial chemicals, naturally occurring poisons, and even environmental pollutants. Risk is the possibility of a specific adverse effect to occur. It is often expressed as a percentage of cases in a given population and during a specific time period. A risk estimate can be based upon actual cases or an estimation of future cases based upon hypothetical calculation. Toxicity rating and toxicity classification can be used for regulatory purposes. Toxicity rating is an arbitrary grading of doses or exposure levels causing toxic effects. These gradings may be super toxic, highly toxic, moderately toxic, and so on. The most common ratings concern acute toxicity. Toxicity classification concerns the grouping of chemicals into generic categories according to their most important toxic effect. And such categories, if we talk about, they include allergenic, neurotoxic, carcinogenic, etc. And this classification can be of administrative value as a warning and as information. Information from the toxicological sciences gained by experience or research has a growing influence on our personal lives as well as on human beings and environmental health across the globe. Knowledge about the toxicological effects of a compound affects the consumer products, drugs, manufacturing processes, waste cleanup, regulatory action, civil disputes, and broad policy decisions. The expanding influence of toxicology on social issues is accompanied by the responsibility to be increasingly sensitive to the ethical, legal, and social implications of toxicological research and testing. Poisoning, if we talk about, has become one of the common medical emergencies throughout the world because thousands of pharmacological and chemical agents are commonly used and their numbers are increasing every year. The incidences of poisoning and substances abuse have been gradually rising in India over the last few decades and it is becoming a very alarming situation. Accurate diagnosis of poisoning is very essential both in living as well as in death. for therapeutic and for medico-legal purposes respectively. Poisons are generally detected in body fluids such as urine, blood, gastric lavage during life, while they are detected in the contents of stomach, bowel and the viscera besides urine and vomitus after death. In a cadaver, one of the better samples to complement blood is vitreous humor, for the reason that it is less likely to degrade quickly and it is equitably easy to collect at the time of autopsy. Forensic toxicological analysis has traditionally focused on the use of body fluids including blood along with certain organs in examinations of deaths due to intoxication. However, in some circumstances, putrefaction and contamination make proper sampling from tissues which are difficult, such as in exhumation cases. In these cases, bone marrow might be useful as an alternative specimen since it is a potential depot for drugs, that the drugs will be accumulated in the bone marrow. Determination of the toxicological potential of these newly created chemicals became the underpinning of the science of toxicology as it is practiced today. The science of toxicology has expanded to include a wide range of interests, including the evaluation of the risks involved in the use of pharmaceuticals, pesticides, food additives, as well as the study of occupational poisoning, exposure to environmental pollution, the effect of radiation, and regretfully, biological and chemical warfare. Nevertheless, it is the forensic toxicologist who has held the title of toxicologist for the longest period of time. The forensic toxicologist is concerned primarily with the detection and estimation of poisons in tissues and body fluids obtained at autopsy or occasionally in blood, urine or gastric material obtained from a living person. Once the analysis is completed, the forensic toxicologist then interprets the result as to the physiological and or behavioral effects of the poison upon the person from whom the sample was obtained. All substances can act as poison if they are used in inappropriate way. This thing you should keep in mind. The inappropriate way may contain their dosage, the state of appearance, and the mode of administration. For example, normal sugar, which is taken in our daily consumption, may act as a trigger to diabetic attack if it is taken in overdose. Similarly, the normal oxygen we inhale may kill a person if even a bubble is injected intravenously. Swiss alchemist and physician Paracelsus, as well as Italian physician Ramazzini, also noted the toxicity of smoke and soot. So even if they are in large amount, that can lead to death. And if it has carbon monoxide, it will be like eventually a very slow death, but it will be. So all these you should know, that otherwise they may not be poisonous if they are in less amount, but if they are in more and the way they are administered, they can be fatal. Now let us try to be familiar with the development and advances of forensic toxicology. We had seen the historical perspective, but now the forensic toxicology has reached to an advanced stage because of the instrumental techniques also available handy to us. So if we talk about in 17th century, in 1781, Joseph Planck stated that the identification and detection of poison in the organs of disease was the only true sign of poisoning. Later in 1813, a Spaniard, Matthew Joseph Orfila, who was working at the University of Paris in the early 19th century, published the first complete work on the subject of poisons and legal medicine. By 1836, James M. Marsh developed a test for the detection of arsenic in body tissue, which is still used to identify the presence of arsenic in homicidal poisoning cases, known as the Marsh test. And there have been some various other advances like Gugis test, then father of American toxicology, it is Alexander O. Gettler. And after the World War II, the contribution of Jean Serviel Stas using a solution of acetic acid in ethyl alcohol to extract nicotine from the tissues of the murdered Gustav Fugin. Then further, German chemist Friedrich Otto, the Stas-Otto method was evolved, which was quickly applied to isolation of numerous alkaloid poisons, including colchicine, cocaine, morphine, narcotine, strychnine, and this method is still used today. In India, the toxicological analysis of viscera is done in the toxicology division of forensic science laboratories or Department of Forensic Medicine of the various medical colleges. Generally, the understanding is that whenever a death case is reported, the body is autopsied under the supervision of senior expert or the head of the department of the forensic medicine department, and the viscera is preserved in such a manner that it can be safely transported to the concerned forensic science laboratory for further analysis. In the forensic science laboratory, after the approval of the director, authorized expert commences the requisite examinations to detect the poisonous substance and accordingly prepare its report. Report provided by forensic toxicology personnel and expert consultants may ultimately be introduced as evidence in the court of law. These reporting individuals may be asked to interpret and substantiate their findings and any associated opinions. It is therefore necessary that the forensic toxicologist be thoroughly knowledgeable or familiar with legal practices and be professionally comfortable in a courtroom environment. As the time passed and the modern innovative techniques crossed through the boundaries of interrelated science, the instrumental intervention significantly enhanced the field of toxicological analysis. Now we have latest instruments with remarkable preciseness facilitated deciphering the crucial dilemmas of the in-depth toxicology examination. It is amply clear that the variety of potential adverse effects and the diversity of chemicals in our environment contribute to make toxicology a very broad field of science. The analytical techniques employed by forensic toxicologists have continued to expand in complexity and improve in reliability and also in terms of sensitivity. Many new analytical tools have been applied to toxicological problems in almost all areas of the field, and the technology continues to open new areas of research. The toxicology and drug identification section of the forensic laboratory utilizes forensic chemistry knowledge and the knowledge of modern instrumental techniques to isolate, identify, and often quantify the alcohol, drugs, poisons, and other toxic materials. The material submitted for analysis may consist of bulk quantities of illicit drugs such as marijuana, heroin, LSD or cocaine, which must be accurately weighed, analyzed and often quantitated to establish the degree of criminal drug charge. Other liquid, solid or gaseous materials may be submitted for analysis to determine the presence of any toxic or poisonous content. Many crime laboratories analyze blood for alcohol and or drug content in the case of driving while impaired or intoxicated, as well as perform the alcohol, drug and toxic substance analysis on the body tissues and fluids for the purpose of death investigation in conjunction with the medical examiner's office. Drugs detected may be either of a prescribed or illicit nature. Some commonly encountered toxic substances are carbon monoxide, cyanides, insecticides and heavy metals. The quantitative blood and tissue levels of these substances as well as their metabolites may reveal therapeutic, toxic or lethal levels present in the body and help determine the role of the substance in the death of that particular individual. Occasionally, the determination of the absence of a prescribed medication such as anticonvulsive drugs in victims known to have seizure disorders may help to explain their behavior or the circumstances of a death. The procedures used in a typical toxicology section of a laboratory may include extraction and purification techniques prior to analysis. Preliminary examination of material may include simple chemical spot test, which by simply looking at the color may indicate the existence of a type of drug or poison, which we'll be studying in detail in subsequent modules. And going to more sophisticated techniques, they include UV, IR, radioimmunoassay, thin layer chromatography, HPLC, gas chromatography, GC. So all these techniques, and now we have also the application of mass spectroscopy, which is commonly employed for the identification of drug and toxic compounds. And you can very well simply, if you have the known spectra, come and compare that whether it is this particular drug or not. So in the subsequent modules, you will come to know that how this analysis is done in detail. So dear students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. So you have been given introduction to the word toxicology, which is derived from the Greek word toxikon, and which in turn was used as a poisonous substance in arrowheads. Poison may be regarded as any substance which when taken in sufficient quantity, note the quantity is very important, will cause ill health or death. The field of toxicology we studied can be further divided into various sub-disciplines like environmental, occupational, regulatory, food, clinical, descriptive, analytical, mechanistic and forensic toxicology. And then we had gone into details of the forensic toxicology. Thank you.